स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक टू गुरुदेव आंध्र क्लासेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स एज यू नो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द यूनिट 3 गैलीलियो एंड दैट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द सम प्री रीडिंग क्वेश्चंस एंड दैट प्री रीडिंग क्वेश्चंस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द व्हाट आर हेवनली बॉडीज। डियर स्टूडेंट्स विच आर द नेचुरल थिंग्स विजिबल इन द स्काई दोज थिंग्स वी आर कॉल्ड एज ए हेवनली बॉडीज। Example: Moon, Sun, Milky Way, Galaxy, and many other things. And also, we have discussed what is astronomy. It is a branch of science. Here, we are studying about the heavenly bodies. Next, astronomers use one of the instrument to see the space. What is that? Yes, that is telescope. By using the telescope, the astronomers studying about the space. Okay, next, name an Indian astronomer. Dear students, do you know that Aryabhatta was an Indian astronomer? He was first Indian astronomer. Dear students, in the last class we have discussed the some of the new words. Okay, dear students, now let us see the explanation in detail. See here, unit 3, Galileo. Dear students, now let us discuss the explanation. It is common knowledge today that the Earth is a planet revolving around the Sun. But there was a time, not many centuries ago, when even learned men believed that the Earth was fixed in space and the Sun and all other heavenly bodies went around it. The man who first brought to light the facts about them was a great scientist and astronomer called Galileo Galilei. He was born in the year 1564 in the Italian town of Pisa. Dear students, it is common knowledge today. What is that? The Earth is a planet revolving around the Sun. It means, see here, this is Sun. The Sun will be here. So, in the solar system, it is static in the solar system. It means it is fixed in the solar system. So, here the Earth. The Earth and other heavenly bodies revolving around the Sun. It is common knowledge today. Everyone, we have believed in this theory. In this theory, we are called as a heliocentric theory. So, helio means Sun. Okay, but there was a time not many centuries ago when even learned men believed that the Earth was fixed in space and the Sun and all other heavenly bodies went around it. But in the ancient time, even the learned people or literated people, literated means who are able to read and write, those people also believed Earth was static. Static means fixed in the solar system. Sun and other heavenly bodies revolving around the Earth. See here, like this. Here this is the Earth. According to that people, the Earth is static in the solar system. And here the Sun. Sun and other heavenly bodies revolving around the Earth. This theory we are called as a geocentric theory. Geo means Earth. So all the literated peoples, they believed in this theory. So today it is common knowledge, everyone we believed in this theory. The Sun is fixed in the solar system, the Earth and the other heavenly bodies revolving around the Sun. But in the ancient time, so all the learned people, they believed that the Earth was static, Sun and other heavenly bodies revolving around the Earth. The man who first brought to light the facts about them was a great scientist and astronomer called Galileo Galilei. Dear students, his full name is Galileo Galilei. He was the first astronomer corrected the people thinking about our Earth in the 17th century. Because everyone, they believed in geocentric theory. So when he came, he corrected the people's thinking about the space. So he was born in the year 1564 in the Italian town of Pisa. See here. His full name is Galileo Galilei. He was born on 15 February in 1564. So he was born on 15 February in 1564 in the Italian town of Pisa. So he was born in Pisa. Where it is located? It is located in the Italian town. Okay, dear students, he is one of the great scientist and astronomer. He corrected the people's thinking about space in the 17th century. Okay, this is the short biography of the Galileo Galilei. Now let us see the second paragraph. In the year 1608, a man called Hans Lippershey, a native of Holland, invented the telescope, the instrument with which astronomers watch the skies. The telescope makes distant objects appear to be near and magnified several times over. See here, in the year 1608, a man called Hans Lippershey. This fellow came before the Galileo. Who is that? Hans Lippershey. In 1608, Hans Lippershey, a native of Holland, invented the telescope. See here, in 1608, Hans Lippershey, invented the telescope. See, the Hans Lippershey, he was one of the great scientists and astronomer. He invented the first telescope. So he was born on 1570 in Holland. The instrument with which astronomers watch the skies. The students, why did the Hans Lippershey invent the telescope? Yes, very good. This is one of the instrument. The astronomers use this instrument to watch the skies. Because, dear students, we can see the sky with our bare eyes. Bare eyes means without wearing any specs or without using any instrument. So we are seeing the sky in our bare eyes. We can see only few things: sun, moon, and some of the stars. But by using the telescope, we can see the out of the sky. It means space. That's why it is very helpful for the astronomers to study about the space. Okay? The telescope makes distant objects appear to be near and magnified several times over. It means it can be seen very near to them. It means sitting here, we can watch the space. Because that instrument magnified several times over. Magnified means made bigger. By using this instrument, easily we can see the space. Okay. Now let us move on to the third paragraph. So when Galileo heard about the invention, he became greatly interested in it. He had at this time begun to study astronomy, and he saw that the invention would be a wonderful aid to the astronomer. He set to work on making a telescope for himself and very soon succeeded in making one which was better than the one Lippershey had made. See, when the Galileo heard the invention of this telescope, he became greatly interested in it. So he was very much influenced by this telescope. He had at this time begun to study astronomy. Because he was very much inspired by this telescope, he started to study about the astronomy. And he saw the invention would be a wonderful aid to the astronomer. And he saw that this telescope is one of the good instrument for the astronomers. Because without instrument, we cannot see the space. So it is very essential for the astronomers to study about the space. Next, He set to work on making a telescope for himself and very soon succeeded in making one which was better than the one Lippershey had made. See, but Galileo was not satisfied with the Hans Lippershey telescope. Again he started to invent a new telescope and very soon succeeded in making one which was better than the one Lippershey had made. But very soon the Galileo succeeded by making one of the new telescope. Compared to the Hans Lippershey telescope, it is better one. Okay, like this Galileo invented the new telescope. Okay, now let us move on to the fourth paragraph. Galileo's telescope was the first that was ever turned towards the stars. Looking through it, he saw 100 times as many stars as he could see with his bare eyes. He looked at the Milky Way, the broad white band of light seen across the sky at night, and found that it contained millions and millions of faint stars. He turned the telescope on the moon, and what he saw filled him with amazement. On the moon's surface, which seems so smooth, he saw high mountains and deep valleys like those on the earth. See, Galileo's telescope was the first that was ever turned towards the stars. When he was invented the telescope, he was turned his telescope towards the stars. Looking through it, he saw 100 times as many stars as he could see with his bare eyes. Dear students, with our bare eyes, we can see some of the stars. But when we are using the telescope, we can see millions and millions of stars, because it is one of the good instrument to see the space. He found millions and millions of stars. So, he looked at the Milky Way, the broad white band of light seen across the sky at night, and found that it contained millions and millions of faint stars.
He looked at the Milky Way. Also, he saw the moon's surface.
By using his telescope, the Galileo found the Milky Way. Dear students, do you know that what is the Milky Way? Very good. Okay, see the answer. The broad white band of light seen across the sky at night and found that it contained millions and millions of faint stars. It is the broad white band of light we can see in the sky and it contains millions and millions of faint stars. Faint stars means not clear. It is not clearly visible in our eyes. He found all these things by using his telescope. Next, he turned the telescope on the moon and what he saw filled him with amazement. So, when he had found the Milky Way, again he turned his telescope to the moon. See, and what he saw filled him with amazement. Sir, he became amazement. Amazement means great surprise. When he was turned his telescope to the moon, he was surprised. Because on the moon's surface, which seems so smooth, he saw high mountains and deep valleys like those on the earth. By seeing this, he became very surprised. He found some mountains and valleys. See here, this is not the mountain, this is the valley. It is quite common on the earth. We can see mountains and valleys on the earth. But in the same way, Galileo found the mountain and the valleys on the moon. By seeing this, the Galileo became very surprised. Because the mountains and valleys are quite common on the earth. So, but when he was turned his telescope on the moon, he found mountains and the valleys. By seeing that, the Galileo became very surprised. Okay, let us move on to the fifth paragraph. Greatly excited by these discoveries, Galileo carried his telescope to Venice and showed it to the learned men of that city. The people of Venice crowded at his house to have a look at the looking tube. They took it to the top of high buildings and looked through it at the ships out in the sea. They saw ships 50 miles away appear to be only 15 miles off. When the ruler of Venice was shown The instrument he was greatly pleased with the invention and appointed Galileo professor for life at the University of Padua. Okay, dear students, when he was invented the telescope, he was very excited because he found many new things in the space. Excited, it means interest. So when he was found Milky Way, mountains and valleys in the space, all these things create interest to Galileo to learn about the space. Okay, see, the Galileo carried his telescope to Venice and showed it to the learned men of that city. So when he was interested in it, he decided to show his telescope to the people of Venice. For that reason, he carried his telescope to Venice and showed it to the learned men of that city. The learned men means literated people. As I said before, literated people, it means who are able to read and write. Those people we are called as a literated people. The people of Venice crowded at his house to have a look at the looking tube. So many the people, they crowded in front of the Galileo's house because to see the looking tube. Here the looking tube means telescope. So all the people, they crowded in front of the Galileo's house to see the telescope. They took it to the top of high buildings and looked through it at the ships out in the sea. So by using the telescope, all they watched the ships. They saw ships 50 miles away appearing to be only 15 miles off. Okay, it means 50 miles. Dear students, as you know, so 1 mile is equals to 1.6 kilometer. Okay, 1 mile is equals to 1.6 kilometer, 50 miles, it means 80 kilometers. So here the real distance of the ship from his building, that is 50 miles or 80 kilometers. But when we can see by using the telescope, it is looking 15 miles off. 15 miles. When they saw by using the telescope, it is appearing to be only 15 miles off.
The people of Venice were also excited to see his telescope and they took it to the top of high buildings and looked through it at the ships out in the sea. They saw ships 50 miles away, appearing to be only 15 miles off.
Okay, next. So when the ruler of Venice was shown the instrument, he was greatly pleased with the invention and appointed Galileo professor for life at the University of Padua. By seeing this, the ruler of Venice, he was very pleased. Pleased means he was very happy by the invention of the telescope and appointed Galileo professor for life at the University of Padua. So, by the invention of the telescope, the ruler of the Venice decided to take Galileo as a professor. It means complete his life, he will be professor in that particular university.
The ruler of Venice was very much impressed by his invention and appointed Galileo professor for life at the University of Padua.
Okay, let us move on to the sixth paragraph. The first telescope that Galileo made magnified objects 3 times their size. Later he made one that magnified them 8 times. But he went on working on larger and larger ones until he made a telescope which brought objects 30 times nearer. So here the Galileo was not satisfied with his invention. So again he decided to improve his telescope. So he started to work out on that way. See, the first telescope that Galileo made magnified objects 3 times their size. The 15 miles distance, it is appearing like a 15 miles. So here he magnified 3 times. But he was not satisfied with this. Again he magnified his telescope 8 times. But he went on working on larger and larger ones until he made a telescope which brought objects 30 times nearer. So again he decided to make larger and larger ones. That's why again he magnified his telescope 30 times nearer. By sitting here, we can easily see the space. So it is very helpful for the astronomer because he magnified 30 times nearer.
Galileo went on improving his telescope. The first telescope that Galileo made magnified objects 3 times their size. Later, he made one that magnified them 8 times. He went on working on larger and larger ones until he made a telescope which brought objects 30 times nearer.
Okay, dear students, by using his much improved telescope, what the invention and discoveries he had done, we will see in the next class. Thank you.